Hello my dear students, hope you all are well at home. I am Anjana Jindal and I welcome you all in my English literature class. So children, today I am going to teach you poem number 6 of our Mulberry book of class 4. And the name of our poem is Cypress Street. So children, before going through the poem, let me tell you something about the poet of this poem, who is Todd Michael St. Pierre. He writes poems, songs and plays for children. He is a storyteller at schools throughout the southern United States. Among his published works are Somewhere as Told by the Parrot and The Louisiana State Bird Beauty Pageant. St. Pierre lives in St. Francisville, Louisiana with his Siamese twin cats. This poem is from Put the People in a Zoo and Set the Animals Free. So children, before going through the explanation of the poem, let me tell you something about the poem. Means what the poem is about. Okay. So children, please tell me one thing, that have you ever noticed any changes in the area in which you live? See, when any of the area is developed, no, then we can see that so many changes occur there, isn't it? Yes. So children, this poem is also about the changes that the poet noticed and got disappointed when he went to the street called Cypress Street. So let's enjoy the poem. So children, let's start the poem. So these are the first four lines of the poem. Let's read once. I took a stroll down Cypress Street, the hot sidewalk beneath my feet. The one thing that stood out the most, where trees once stood, there were lampposts. So children, these lines are all about how poet went to the Cypress Street and what he felt when he walked down the street. See, I took a stroll down Cypress Street, the hot sidewalk beneath my feet. So children, here stroll means walk slowly. Okay, stroll down means slowly walk down. And the sidewalk, you know, sidewalk is a path at the side of the road for people to walk on. Okay, that is a sidewalk. So children, in these lines, poet slowly walked down the Cypress Street like as he went for a walk. He was bare feet. The hot sidewalk beneath my feet means he was bare feet. That's why he was able to feel the hot path which took him to the Cypress Street. Now, the one thing that stood out the most, where trees once stood, there were lampposts. So children, here stood out means was easy to see. Okay, one thing that was easy to see. So children, here in these lines, see, when he walked down the street, the first thing which came in his view were lampposts. And the poet became gloomy. Can you tell why poet became gloomy? Yes, because he was disappointed after seeing the lampposts. And why he became disappointed? Yeah, because he wished for trees standing there instead of lampposts. But for his surprise, he saw lampposts and all trees were cut down. As the name of the street is Cypress Street, so he was expecting trees over there. But he was surprised to see the lampposts all over. So children, now let's read next four lines of the poem. I had never seen so much concrete, no cypress left on Cypress Street. According to my great aunt Jim, there used to be a lot of them. So children, here poet is saying that I had never seen so much concrete. You know what is concrete? Concrete is a building material. It's made up of broken stones, cement, water and sand. So used to make buildings and all. Okay. So I had never seen so much concrete, no cypress left on cypress street. So children, in these lines, poet has used humor. And how he used the humor? Yes, by taunting. By taunting and saying that he has never seen this much concrete in his whole life. You know, why poet taunted about this? Yeah, because once on that street, cypress trees used to stand proudly. And so the street was named on those trees as Cypress Street. Okay. But now there was no existence of those trees. No existence of the trees. And instead of the trees, now lampposts are standing proudly. So in this disbelief that how they harmed the nature, he taunted that he has never seen so much concrete in his life. And no cypress trees for which the street was famous were left. Okay. Now, according to my great aunt Jim, there used to be a lot of them. So here, the poet said that his great aunt Jim used to tell him that street consisted of lots of cypress trees. But did he find them? No. He didn't find any cypress tree about which his great aunt Jem told him. And children, you know why he brought the topic about great aunt Jem? I think because of his excitement, which was now vanished. See children, when our grandparents narrate beautiful view of something, no, then we get the curiosity to experience that view, no? So in the same way, the poet was also excited to see the street full of trees, how his great aunt narrated. But his dreams shattered into pieces as the street was now left with no trees. So children, now let's read the last few lines of the poem. Let's read. They cut them down, they took their wood. A treeless street is plumb no good, just like a treeless neighborhood. So tell the mayor next time they meet to change the name to Lamppost Street. So children, here he's saying that they cut them down, they took their wood. A treeless street is plumb no good, just like a treeless neighborhood. So children, here plumb no good. Plumb no good means which is not good, means you can say useless, which is not good, right? So children, here poet talked about how mercilessly they cut down all the trees and took their wood. He was angry because for the sake of development, they harmed the nature for which the place was famous. As the place was famous for the cypress trees only, no? That's why the street was named Cypress Street. So the poet was fuming with anger and said that a treeless street is useless. Means it's of no use. Now what is the use of this street without the cypress trees? So the poet had a point, of course. Children, tell me, if a place is famous for trees and you find no tree over there, then is the place useful to visit? No? Yeah. So similarly, poet also felt useless to visit that street. He compared that street to a treeless neighborhood. And why? Why he made such comparison? Because as we are developing, we are cutting down trees in our neighborhood, and the same happened with the cypress street. So tell the mayor next time they meet to change the name to Lamppost Street. So children, mayor, you know who is a mayor? Mayor is the head of a town. Okay, yeah. So here the poet was so disappointed that he didn't find what street stood for. So he asked the people over there in the neighborhood that when next time mayor means who is the head of the town, next time comes for a city check, no? So, and if they meet him, then they should surely suggest him to change the name of the street from Cypress Street to Lamppost Street. And why a poet suggested this? Because now, as no cypress is present over there, no existence of the cypress trees is there. So what is the use of the name Cypress Street when all over their lamppost are stored there? So better to keep the name as Lamppost Street. So this is what poet suggested. So children, this was all about the poem Cypress Street. So children, I hope you all have understood and enjoyed the poem well. So now it's a time for your home assignment. In your homework, you have to read the poem again and learn and write the poem in your mulberry copy neatly. Okay children, bye bye.